Miraculous Monday. Man, I am super excited. I have had an awesome weekend, a blessed weekend. I do not own the rights to this music. This is Love Myself by Olivia. Again, I do not own the rights to this music in the background. This is Love Myself by Olivia. And I just want to welcome you to Miraculous Monday. I'm going to give some people time to tune in. Stages of the movie, from her having pretty hair to her going bald. I can't remember every stage of the movie, but I watched how in the beginning she was with a man that did not really love her. He loved her beauty and her hair, and then she didn't really love herself. So after the movie went off, I began to talk to my niece, and in the middle of the movie, I told her, you are not your hair, because we were just talking about hair. And after the movie, she wanted to play in my hair. My hair was exactly like this, and she wanted to play in my hair. And as she began to rub through my hair, she said, man, Chrissy, I love your hair. It is so beautiful. Like, your curls are so perfect. And she was like, I don't think you have 4C hair like me. You have 4A hair. And me, I don't know the difference, because I honestly don't care about what type of curls I have. I don't let my hair define me. And so she said, you don't have hair like me. Your hair is prettier than mine. And I'm sitting there, I'm like, And so she was like, yes, your hair, I love your curls. And she was just rubbing through my hair. She was like, they're so pretty. And so I paused, and I told her, I said, sweetie, I said, we just watched Napoli Ever After, and did you pay attention to the different stages? And did you see that her hair does not define her? And so I had to let her know that just because I have this type of hair, it does not define me. Just because you have your particular type of hair, it does not define you. You have to love yourself no matter what type of hair you have, no matter what type of skin you have, no matter what your skin tone is, you still have to love yourself. My hair does not define me. I get it all the time. I love your curls. They're so beautiful. It's just like the perfect curls. But I don't allow my hair to define me. I switch my hair up from hair colors to sometimes I wear a weave. Sometimes I get, oh, your hair is so beautiful with having weave in my hair. Sometimes I get, oh, your hair is so pretty with my curls. So we begin to talk, and I'm talking to an 11-year-old, and she's saying, I don't like my hair. I wish I had hair like yours. And I'm just sitting there, and I'm pondering on what she's saying, and I'm taking in everything that she's saying. Because sometimes you have to think before you speak to children. And so I begin to let her know that you are beautiful the way you are. I love your hair. And I asked her to let her hair down. And I let her know how beautiful she was. And I began to rub her hair. And I said, it doesn't matter if your curls are not like mine. It doesn't matter if you can't use a particular product and your hair doesn't curl like mine. You are still beautiful inside and out. You have a wonderful heart. You have a beautiful smile. And your hair is beautiful. It doesn't matter. Stop comparing yourself to other people. Don't compare yourself to me. You are beautiful the way you are inside and out. And sometimes you just gotta love yourself. It don't matter what people say about you. They can talk about your hair and say your hair is ugly, it's nappy, it don't look good, you look ratchet. They can talk about your clothes or what you wear. Now don't get me wrong, don't walk out the house looking any kind of way. But let people talk about the way you look, because you have to learn to love yourself. You have to learn to walk in the skin that you are in. You have to learn that you are God's masterpiece, and you have to learn that you are fearfully and wonderfully made. Don't pay attention to what man says about you. I accepted that she said my hair was beautiful, but my hair does not define me. My skin does not define me. What truly defines me is what my heart is like. Do I love myself? Am I my true self? Or am I worried about what everybody else say about me? Am I allowing what people say about my hair to allow me to be cocky and stuck up? No. I choose to learn to love myself. I choose to wear my hair like this, walk with confidence, and I let her know, walk with your shoulders up, your head held up high, your shoulders back. Walk with confidence and love your hair the way it is. Love yourself. Because I love myself. It doesn't matter what people say about me. Sometimes I have bad hair days, and I still walk with my head held high, with my shoulders back. I walk like the queen I am. And I know y'all are probably reading my shirt, and I wore this shirt on purpose today because I am strong. I am blessed. I am a black woman that is strong, beautiful, and blessed. And I don't care what nobody say about me. My hair don't define me. The way I look don't define me. It's what my heart like. What am I like on the inside? I'm still going to love myself. Does God love me the way I am? I don't allow my jewelry to define me, my clothes to define me, my hair to define me. I'm going to love myself no matter what. This past week, I have really did a reflection on myself. I looked in the mirror, because sometimes when I look in the mirror, I don't truly love myself. So I began to look in the mirror this week, and I said, man, I love myself. There's one thing that I don't like about myself, and I've never told nobody about this. But when I was younger, I woke up and I was in third grade, and my eye was red. I was at school. My eye was red, and I began to cry. So then years down the line, I didn't know what the problem was with my eye, and I found out that I had a scar on my retina. A scar on my retina in my right eye. And because I have that scar on my retina in my right eye, that right eye travels, so it's a lazy eye. So I was teased when I was in middle school, and I was teased when I was in high school, and I was talked about. And every time I always get, are you looking at me? And being a professor and being a substitute teacher, I always got, are you looking at me? So when I never look people in their eyes when they're talking to me, because I was so ashamed of my right eye. I was so ashamed for people to see. So when I would talk to them, I would rub my right eye, and they'd be like, is everything okay? And I'm like, I'm good. My allergies just bother me. And I'd just be lying. I'd be like, my allergies bother me, and just be lying. Because I was so ashamed of my right eye and the way it was. But this past weekend, when I was talking to my sister, for the first time ever, I looked her straight in her eyes and I talked to her. And I was not ashamed about my right eye traveling. For the first time ever, I learned to love myself and to truly be me. For the first time ever, I chose to embrace the flaw of my right eye traveling when I look at people. I chose to look someone in straight in their eyes and not be ashamed. And to be transparent, when my right eye does travel, I'm ashamed, but I don't care what people say anymore. So what they talk about me and say, are you looking at me? So what they say, oh, your right eye travels. I don't even care anymore. I choose to love myself. I choose to embrace my flaws. I remember being in high school, being talked about, in middle school, being talked about because of my size and my eye together. I was so ashamed. I was like, they talk about my size and they talk about my eye. It was so bad to the point I didn't even want to go to school. And then going to college, I remember my freshman year of college, going to school, I met with the counselor and she was talking to me. And I looked her straight into her eyes and she said, I don't know if you're paying attention to me, but it seems like you're not paying attention to me. That very moment, I wanted to cry because I knew that I was teased in middle school and high school about my eye. And for her to say that very thing about my eye, are you sure you're paying attention to me and not know my story, not know my situation? A lot of times people look at you and they don't even know your story. They don't know the hurt you've been through. They don't know what it takes for you to love yourself. They don't know all the pain that you endure to love yourself. But they talk. They talk about your size, they talk about your eyes, they talk about your mouth, they talk about any little thing, and they don't know the pain that you endure. So that counselor said that one particular word, I don't know if you're paying attention to me, but you seem as though you're not paying attention to me. Not knowing my story and my background history of me having a scar on my retina causing that eye to travel. Not knowing that I'm dealing with self-confidence and self-esteem issues with my eyes. Not knowing that I did not love myself that very moment because I was teased in middle school and high school. And I'm just learning to embrace who I am. Just learning to love myself. And again, I don't own the rights to this music. This is I Love Myself by Olivia. But just having to deal with that hurt. And still today, I still go into stores and I have people looking at me funny because of my eye. But when I learn to love myself, I don't have to worry about what people say. I don't have to worry about the way they look at me because of my eye. I don't have to worry about what people say my hair is pretty or they don't like my hair because I love myself. I'm strong, I'm bold, I'm courageous. I learned to love me. I love myself. Helen says, let me tell you something, sis. The same thing happened to me, but guess what? We are beauty. I love me some me. I love me some me too, sis. I'm learning to love myself more and more each day. I'm learning not to let other people's words define me, what they say about me. I'm learning to love myself because I need to love myself despite what they say. So I challenge you, my queens and my kings, to love yourself no matter the way you look. No matter if you have an eye issue, no matter your size, no matter what your hair look like, love yourself. Because you are strong, you are bold, you are courageous, you are more than a conqueror, and you are fearfully and wonderfully made. God designed you the way he wanted you to look, not the way people wanted you to look. So learn to love yourself no matter what. And as this song says, I love myself. Olivia sings this song. Just learn to love yourself. I love myself the way I am. Why care about what people think? So learn to love yourself. Queens, walk with your head held high, your shoulders back, and love yourself no matter what. Walk with boldness. Kings, wear your crown. Love yourself. Don't worry about what people say, because I love myself. And today I challenge you ladies to love yourself as well, no matter what. Stop trying to hide behind the mask because of what people say. I did it for a very long time. I did not love myself. I hid behind a mask because of what people said. But I learned to love myself no matter what. I learned to walk with confidence. I learned to know who I am. I learned to know that God still loves me despite my flaws. I learned that I'm fearfully and wonderfully made. I learned that I'm not what the world and society says about me. I am who God called me to do. I am who God says I am. So I love myself. So I challenge you today to love yourself. Just learn to love yourself, just like Olivia sang in this song. Learn to love yourself. So you have tuned in to Miraculous Monday, and I challenge you today to let everything go that people have said about you and love yourself no matter what. Walk in that confidence, wear your crown, queens and kings, and know that you are beautiful, queens and kings. You are handsome. Don't worry about what people say about you. Love yourself. Thank y'all for tuning in to Miraculous Monday. I love myself. And those that will catch the replay as well, thank y'all for tuning in. This song in the background is Love Myself by Olivia. I'm Krishandria Jane, CEO and founder of Blossom Up LLC, where I teach teen girls, young ladies, and women to blossom up and bloom where they have been planted by helping them embrace their inner beauty and helping them grow, evolve, and transform into your true self. So go through that growth. Grow through that transformation. Evolve, transform, and learn to love yourself. Don't worry about what people say. Because I need to love myself, and you need to love yourself too. This is Miraculous Monday. I love myself, and we're going to rock it out with Olivia. Love myself. And I'll play the music for a little bit, and then I'm going to be out. Can't love anybody else until you love yourself.
No matter how hard I try or what I do, I just can never seem to impress you.
Thank y'all for tuning in to Miraculous Monday. I love myself. I do not own the rights to this music. This is Olivia. Love myself.
Me and it's all my fault, but I'm done with that and I finally figured out. I don't need to be the same as everyone else. I just need to learn to love.
Miraculous Monday. Y'all have a wonderful and miraculous week. I will see y'all again for Freedom Friday. Have a wonderful, blessed, and miraculous week. See y'all on Friday.